Hi, I'm Martin White. I'm a year 13 at Sacred Heart College, and I've been riding horses since I was little. I'm going to see if a career in the equine industry is right for me.
The New Zealand equine industry is a big player on the world stage, and there are lots of possible career opportunities for Martin to choose from thoroughbred racing, harness racing, breeding, and racecourse management. To give Martin a taster of the industry, he's going to meet horse breeders, spend some time at a harness racing stable, and sample a day in the life at one of New Zealand's top thoroughbred racing stables. Equine life invariably starts at the horse breeders, and to kick off his experience, Martin is spending the day here at Windsor Park Stud Farm in Cambridge in the mighty Waikato.
Hey, Martin. Roddy Schick, mate. Welcome to Windsor Park.
Thank you.
So they tell me you're interested in the thoroughbred industry?
Yeah, just want to see what's available.
Oh, that's great, mate. There's some great opportunities in the industry, so here's a bit of gear, mate, and let's go and have a look around.
All right, thank you.
Windsor Park Stud was started back in the early 70s. Mum and Dad started the farm. Actually had more stallions than mares. We had a couple of stallions and a mare, but the farm's been built over coming up 40 years. The farm employs around 35 to 40 permanent staff, but we get up to around 50 staff during the breeding season when we have seasonal staff come in. So there's a lot of opportunity for people to come through from just starting at the bottom, working their way through the ranks and getting good management positions.
Windsor Park has built up from 100 acres to now around 1,200 acres, producing a number of good stallions over the years.
So Martin, the breeding industry really, for us, we have two forms of income for the stud. The first income really comes from the stallions. So we stand stallions for a service fee. Mm-hmm. And our range is probably from 7,000 up to about 25,000. The second form of income is the income we take from the selling yearlings. So we have between 120 and 140 broodmares. They'll go and foal to our stallions, or stallions we have shares in at other farms. Take the foals through from foaling right through to the yearling sales. And at the yearling sales, you know, they're sold there. And we usually sell anywhere from 70 to 90 yearlings a year.
With such a big operation, a full-time vet is needed to ensure the health of all the breeding stock. Patrick Sells is the vet at Windsor Park.
The basic veterinary care of brood mares involves regular scanning of the fetus. So this mare was covered by the stallion 45 days ago, and we scan mares three times during early gestation for two reasons. Firstly, to make sure that baby is healthy inside, and second of all, to make sure there aren't two of them. Horses aren't designed to have twins. So one of the big things we're looking for is a twin, just to make sure that fetus is on its own.
Using an ultrasound scanner, Patrick checks the health of the fetus.
So that you can just see the spinal column of the fetus down the bottom there.
How many horses would you scan in a day?
So a busy day in mid-season would be, we'd be scanning 40 or 50 mares each morning. And that's not just doing what we've just done looking at pregnancies. We'd be looking at ovaries and determining when that mare's ready to go and see the stallion.
Okay, Martin, what we're going to do now, we're going to go and handle some foals. So on the farm, once the foals are born, they've been running with their mothers for probably three to 4 months. Now's their time to start doing a bit of education. We've got to teach them how to pick their feet up. We've got to teach them how to wear a halter and how to lead.
The foals can be quite nervous, so staying close and being confident gives them the security they need.
So Martin, when you hold the lead and the tail rope in your left hand, keep your right hand on the wither, okay? And if you need to use a bit of pressure there, but it's important to keep that little bit of pressure on the top. So if you take that, just move in. As I say, keep that contact nice and solid in there. January time is when we sell the yearlings from the previous year. Very important time for us, the sales at the end of January, and it's probably one of our major incomes for the year. So August is the foaling time, so the mares foal from August right through to December. And in that period, we're also mating. In September, we start the yearling prep. Big thing now, give her a bit of love. And as I say, she got a little bit hot there, but you know, being outside for one of the first times, being in a bit bigger area.
Yeah.
So no, you did really well. All right, Martin, we'll just go around here. Meet Brendan. Brendan, this is Martin.
Hi, mate.
Brendan Harrison has been at Windsor Park for 4 years and is completing a national certificate in equine breeding.
Foals get fed twice a day. Got to look when we're checking up, we're looking for any cuts, bangs, any runny noses, runny eyes, just anything that's abnormal, make sure they're healthy. And so that happens twice a day. So if there's any problems, we can get the vet out to have a look. Education's always so important for people. The on-farm training really suits us because, you know, it's important to learn the way we like things done, and every farm has a different way. But also they get those fundamental educational things through the course. The most important thing for me with young people is that you're willing to learn and to work hard. Having the ability to learn and listen is so important. And if you can do those two things, you'll probably go a long way.
So how are you finding your apprenticeship?
I find it really good, you know. It's very helpful and it gets in depth, and you always learn a lot of new different things every day.
There are opportunities to become broodmare managers or yearling managers on a stud, and many studs will send their young staff to do a season in the Northern Hemisphere in the off-season to gain more experience at some of the largest studs in Europe or the USA.
So, Martin, what we've seen today so far is, you know, we've seen the babies on the mothers, handling on their mothers and that process. Then we've seen them going to be weaned. Then the next process after they've been weaned and gone through a sale prep is to be broken and to be taught how to ride. Yeah, so these horses, they're going to come out today. This is their first time out around the big track. And Joe and Brennan will just take them for a nice, easy canter, trot and canter around the track. So hopefully there'll be no problems. Yeah, the thoroughbred industry is very important. I know within the racing industry, there's about nearly 50,000 people employed. And the thoroughbred part of that is significant. So it is a big industry, and it's very important to the New Zealand economy.
The equine industry offers many career paths, and the primary ITO offers NZQA qualifications with the trainee in mind. So the training offered is individualised and delivered primarily in the workplace. You also have the support, as the trainee, you'll have the support of your local training advisor who's an expert in the area that you're studying.
All right, Martin, well, thanks for coming down today and spending a bit of time at Windsor Park. What did you think of the thoroughbred breeding side of things?
Yeah, no, it's been really good, thanks. It's cool to have a look in.
Well, all the best for your future, mate, and hope we see you in the breeding side of things.
Cheers. So now that I've looked at breeding, I'm going to head to Takanini to see about a career in harness racing.
The primary ITO offers both Level 3 and Level 4 national certificates in equine breeding. The Level 3 certificate is suitable for people with some experience in the equine industry who want to develop the skills and knowledge required to work as a stud assistant. To be eligible for the Level 4 qualification, you must first complete the Level 3 certificate. Training is primarily delivered in the workplace, so you earn while you learn.
Hi, I'm Martin White. I've just been at a stud farm, so now I'm going to look at harness racing.
There are over 3,000 harness racing horses in New Zealand today, and they race for over $28 million in prize money annually. Harness racing horses can either be trotters or pacers. Trotters trot around the track pulling the cart, properly known as the sulky. Pacers also pull a sulky, but their trotting style is different. And so a race will either be made up of all trotters or all pacers. The person in control of the horse who sits on the sulky is called the driver. Martin is at the well-known Barry Purdon Racing Stables in Takanini.
Martin.
Hey.
Welcome to the stables.
Thank you.
Yeah, good. You're looking forward to your day?
Yeah, it should be good.
Good, good. Well, let's get you started.
Okay.
Yeah. Come on, mate.
Barry Purdon is one of New Zealand's most successful trainers in harness racing, winning most major cups and derbies over the past few decades. And it's a business that he knows a lot about.
My dad was a successful trainer in harness racing, and actually his father was too, so it was always sort of going to carry on, I guess. So I started with dad at an early age and worked our way through there. We trained in partnership for a long time. Yeah, it's been a family thing that's just carried on.
Martin will be learning the ropes with junior driver Sean Grayling.
Sean, this is Martin.
Hey, it's going good.
We're going to go and brush these two horses if you want to come and watch and give me a hand. Okay.
At the stables, they're set up to work racehorses, developing them from a young age through to a stage where they can race. These horses have already been out on the track today, so it's part of Sean's job to attend to their needs.
So how long have you been working here as an apprentice?
I've been working for Barry just over 2 years, and I started my apprenticeship when I come here too. And nothing's been better. I love working the horses and couldn't be happier, really.
You know, we employ about seven people. We've got our own track, 900 metre track. So everything on this place is, as I say, set solely up for that.
Now we're just going to pick his feet out and all the feet with this hoof oil. It helps keep the feet nice and healthy and growing good. So he's pretty clean feet anyway, but just get the little bits out. That's just little bits of shell in there.
Sean is on the Harness Racing New Zealand Cadet Scheme, working towards a national certificate with the primary ITO.
We do a few practicals a year. Like, I think we did a horse dissection last year, which was quite interesting, something different, and then had a practical day driving behind the mobile bear and standing starts, which is how you start most races. And we've done a few, like learning how to put fences up and handyman skills, and it's quite good. I think we're meant to do a farrier course soon, so that's always handy. That's looking good, man.
Sean was the number one cadet in the North Island last year, so Martin is in good hands.
Listen here, Martin, this is our sort of tack room. We've got our dress rugs we won from races, and then down here we've got all our saddles and bridles and that, and then we also got a gym here for the workers, sort of help keep them fit if they need to.
So is it important to be strong and keep fit as a driver?
To a certain extent, like, you don't want to be like sort of too muscly and too heavy because it's not going to do any advantage, but you've got to have the strength, enough strength to hold them if they do get a little bit keen, which...
Unlike thoroughbred racing, where jockeys tend to be quite small, in harness racing there are no weight restrictions.
There's no weight on the horse's back, so when you actually put yourself into a cart, into a sulky, we actually tie them down because the cart will probably just flip over backwards, and so it actually lifts the horse a wee bit.
Before they get out on the track, they need to saddle up the horses.
Harness racing horses, standard bred pacers these two are. This is the harness for them.
Pacers and trotters use the same harness setup, but the pacers have hobbles around their legs.
So this is the bridle, Martin. Goes on, got a head check and a shadow roll on.
The sulky is the cart that the driver sits in, so Martin is given a rundown of the safety aspects and what he'll need to know, including wearing a safety helmet while driving.
In harness racing, the drivers sit in the sulky and drives the horse behind there. So I'll show you a few safety aspects and how to get in the cart and that. So we'll grab the reins here, just flick it over their bum and put the reins in there. And you want to sit on the reins when you get in too. Feet up in the footrest, get your hands up nice and ready. So normally sort of that or that, sort of the way most people like to drive. But
is there anything I have to think about when I'm driving?
When you go out into the track and driving, when you go through gates, make sure you go right through the centre. It's because you've got the cart, so it drags on a bit. The horses don't take much attention to it.
Now it's Martin's turn to get in the driver's seat.
Practically learning, I've just been improving my driving every time because you can always got to learn different horses, different things, and like just learning like Barry's ways. You sort of pay attention to Barry because he's one of the best of all time, and just really watch what he does and how he does it and how he goes about the horses and trains them, and just learn so much. Try and learn as much as you can off everyone. Now, before we let you go out on your own on this horse, we'll put it in the dual seater and I'll come out with you.
With their safety gear on, Martin and Sean head out onto the track.
Come on. When you're driving along, just be alert, just in case of anything, just sort of watch the ears and the ears movement.
As a junior driver, Sean needs to drive over 10 winners before he can race at a premier night. And with more experience, there's a number of opportunities out there in harness racing.
You could even go anywhere in the world, really, with horses. You've got a bit of horse school and that, the right qualifications. A lot of people will take you on, so go anywhere.
It's a great industry. It's you're outdoors, and most people have the love of the horse, of course, and that's why they're really in it. So, it can be rewarding.
What did you think about your first time driving a standard bred in the cart?
Yeah, no, it was good fun, eh?
Joy, what was the best part?
Oh, probably when we went a bit faster.
We had a canter. It was good.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought he went well. You can tell he's had experience. You know, he fitted in straight away, so no, he'll make the grade.
Harness racing offers a very exciting career path in harness stable procedures and also in harness driving. The qualifications that we offer from the primary ITO are NZQA endorsed as well, and also have the backing of the harness racing industry.
Yeah, I had a really good day today working with Sean and looking after the horses, seeing how they do things around here. And the sulky driving was really cool and quite exciting.
The primary ITO offers a level 3 national certificate in stable procedures with a strand in harness racing stable assistant. The qualification is suitable for people involved with horses in supervised roles as harness racing stable assistants. The level 4 qualification follows on from level 3 and delivers the training needed to become a harness driver on race day. Training is primarily delivered in the workplace, so you earn while you learn.
Hi, I'm Martin White, I've already looked at breeding and harness racing, so now I'm here to see what thoroughbred racing's all about.
Think about horse racing, and most people think about thoroughbred racing. In the sport of kings, there are a number of important elements: the horse, the track, the weather, and the jockey. A career as a jockey can be highly rewarding, and New Zealand has a proud tradition of producing champions. Martin is simply too big to become a jockey, but thoroughbred horse training could be a career for him. It's a big industry in New Zealand, and today Martin is in Matamata, home to over 500 thoroughbred horses. He'll be spending the day at Te Ako Stables, where the day starts early at the local training track.
Martin, is it?
Good. Tommy has it, mate. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good. They tell me you're interested in the thoroughbreds.
Yeah, you can have a look around.
Oh, that's good. Well, mate, I tell you what, we've got a pretty full-on day for you, so we might as well get into it, eh?
Hey, cheers.
Oh, yeah.
Despite the 4 a.m. start, there's no messing around, and Martin gets straight to work unloading horses off the float.
Oh, well, a typical day is there. It's early starts. You need to have a passion for it, because when the alarm goes off at 3:30, 6 days out of seven, you know, it'd be quite hard work sometimes. But no, we just get up and we get the horses worked. We like to have them worked and back in the yard, and their breakfast fed by 9:30.
This morning, there's 68 horses to work at the track, and like a well-oiled machine, everyone has a job to do.
All right, Martin, well, we might just give old Kajiro a weigh and a lead, mate. He raced yesterday, so we don't want to work him this morning. We just trot him up to make sure that he's sound and that he's not lame and that sort of thing. So if you pop a rearing bit on him, we'll take him down and put him on the scales, mate.
Each horse is trained as an individual on a daily basis, depending on what stage they're at.
He's only lost 6 kilos in 24 hours. That's not a bad effort for a horse that size, you know?
Tom was brought up with horses and started riding when he was 4 years old.
I always wanted to be a jockey. You know, at the age when all the other kids at school were saying, I want to be a fireman, I want to be a policeman, I was always wanting to be a jockey. So, you know, I was very fortunate that that path worked out for me. And it's been a happy and successful career.
But not everyone working in the thoroughbred industry has come from a background in horses. Jason Bridgman was a teenager when he first went to the races.
It all started with a real passion for racing and horses, and I applied for a weekend part-time job, and next thing I knew, I was really hooked to it, and it's just something I'm really passionate about, and I'm lucky that it's a job that it's my favourite pastime as well. Training a horse is a long process. Many people won't realise when they see the end product race day how much work has gone in to get to that point. Often take at least a year, sometimes longer, for particular horses to get to that point.
Throughout a morning, there'll be different aspects of training depending on the targets for the week. Younger horses may still be getting educated, whereas the older horses that are already racing may get a hard physical workout.
Righto, Martin, well, we're going to give this big bloke a swim. He galloped yesterday, so just to keep the pressure off of him for that a little bit, we swim quite a few horses, so we'll...
Obviously don't want to be working in the heat of the day, so the cool of the morning's the ideal time to train them, and the tracks, etc., aren't at their best come once they dry out. So really we want to be in early, in the cool air of the morning, the horses work at their best and have the best recovery.
Later in the morning, Martin is out on the track with racecourse manager Graham Stiles.
So what's going on here?
Martin, what we have here is jump out morning at the track. It's early training, early education for young horses.
The jump outs are a training tool for teaching young horses to perform from a standing start out of the starting gates, where they have to jump away and straight into a gallop. It can take probably up to, you know, maybe 20 sessions of going through a gate before they're at that efficient level to go racing.
So what do we have to watch out for?
Things to watch out for are young horses. They're often a little bit fractious, a little bit nervous about going to the barriers, so hence the barrier attendants, the race day attendants, to help load them.
After a full morning at the track, Martin is back at Te Ako Stables to help bring in the horses.
In the afternoons is a pretty simple process. Every horse gets brushed, or stropping up is what we call it, has their legs checked, their hooves painted with oil in the afternoon to keep their hooves right, and then we feed them.
Daniel Miller is an apprentice jockey and works at the stables, so Martin will be giving him a hand.
Martin, this is Daniel Miller.
Hey.
Yeah, Martin, you're right. All good. Basically, what we've got left to do is just muck out Krug and Scotty's box.
Daniel has been riding for 11 years and is at the track each morning working with the horses.
So how's your apprenticeship?
It's going good. I'm my second year now.
Started off riding on the flat. Unfortunately, got a bit too tall. So now riding over jumps, and it's going real good.
It's particularly poignant in our game. They have to have a love of the horses. Horses are quiet animals. They like to be treated quietly. The young people involved in the racing game have to have a good nature themselves.
What's your main goal for the future?
Well, just to keep improving my style personally and just riding a few more winners and just working towards a 5-year goal of hopefully moving over to England, working in a jump shout over there, riding full-time there.
You know, it's a great industry to be in if you work hard and you're diligent at what you do. The old saying, have saddle, will travel. If you're professional enough and you can ride a bit, well, you can end up anywhere. Hey, well, listen, that's been the end of a pretty early and long morning. How do you think you went?
Yeah, that was real good. I didn't realise the thoroughbred racing industry was so big and there's so much stuff you could do.
Look, thanks very much for all the help you've given us this morning.
Cheers.
Wish you all the best in the future, and if you're ever looking for a holiday job, based on what I've seen this morning, you'll be sure to give me a ring.
Thank you, will do.
The thoroughbred industry is huge in New Zealand, and the careers that it offers are very rewarding. Most people come in initially as a stable assistant and working on the ground with horses, and then once they've achieved those skills, they will, if they have the desire and the stature, can move on into becoming an apprentice jockey.
So over the last few days, I've looked at horse breeding, harness racing and thoroughbred racing, and it's been really cool. Like, all three industries are really awesome, and I'm definitely going to have to look further into all of them, and it's been an awesome opportunity.
The primary ITO offers a Level 3 National Certificate in Stable Procedures with a strand in Thoroughbred Stable Assistant and Thoroughbred Track Rider. The National Certificate Level 4 delivers the skills and knowledge to become a licensed jockey to ride on race day. Training is primarily delivered in the workplace, so you earn while you learn. For more information about careers in the equine industry, contact the primary ITO.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand On Air.